Sir John Owen came to a lady young and fair. May Calvin was this lady's name, and her father's only heir. Her father's only heir. He wooed her while she spun the thread, and while they made the hay, until he gained her low consent to mount and ride away, to mount and ride away. It's bring me some of your father's gold, and some of your mother's fee. I'll take thee to some far off land, and there I'll marry thee, and there I'll marry thee. She's gone into her father's coffer, where all of his monies lay. She's took the yeller and left the white, and lightly skipped away, and lightly skipped away. She's gone into her father's stables, where all of his steeds did stand. She's took the best and left the worst in all of her father's land, in all of her father's land. She's mounted on a milk-white steed, and he on a dapple gray, and they roll till they come to a lonesome spot, a cliff by the side of the sea, a cliff by the side of the sea. Lie down, said false Sir John, your bridal bed you see. It's seven women have I drowned here, and the eighth one you shall be, and the eighth one you shall be. Have off your Holland smock, with borders all around, for it's too costly to lay down here, and rot on the cold, cold ground, and rot on the cold, cold ground. Cast off your silk so fine, and lay them on a stone, for they're too fine and costly to rot in the salt sea foam, to rot in the salt sea foam. Take off your silken stays, likewise your handsome shoes, for they're too fine and costly to rot in the sea with you, to rot in the sea with you. Turn around, thou false Sir John, and look at the leaves on the tree, for it don't become a gentleman a naked woman to see, a naked woman to see. Oh, false Sir John has turned around to gaze at the leaves on the tree. She's made a dash with her tender little arms and pushed him into the sea, and pushed him into the sea. Oh, help now, May Colvin. Oh, help, or I shall drown. I'll take thee back to thy father's house and lightly set thee down, and lightly set thee down. No help, no help, said May Colvin. No help will you get from me, for the bed's no colder to you, sir, than you thought to give to me, than you thought to give to me. She mounted on the milk-white steed and led the dapple gray, and rode till she come to her father's house at the breaking of the day, at the breaking of the day. Then up and spoke that little parrot, said, May Colvin, where have you been? And what have you done with false Sir John that went with you riding, that went with you riding? Oh, hold your tongue, my pretty parrot, and tell no tales on me, and I'll buy you a cage of beaten gold with spokes of ivory, with spokes of ivory.